In this video, I'm going to be showing you how to model this really cool curtain wall facade in Revit. It's actually really simple if you know what you're doing, and I'm going to be showing you everything step by step. Let's go. Now, quickly before we jump into Revit, I would just like to ask you to check out my website, balkanarchitect.com. I'm going to link it up in the cards above and then also down in the description of this video. We are an Autodesk authorized training center and we offer Revit training. We have over 150 hours of content dedicated to all of the complex and advanced topics in Revit. And we also offer Autodesk certification. Now, without any further ado, let's jump straight into Revit. And here we are in Revit, and this is the building that I'm going to be using for this demonstration. So we basically have just a basic wall here, and this is something that we want to turn into this really cool curtain wall. So the first step is going to be to turn this into a curtain wall. So I'm just going to select that wall, turn it into storefront, and this is what that's going to look like. Now, obviously, this doesn't look very good, so let's make some modifications. The first step is going to be to go here to edit type, and then I'm going to change the spacing for the vertical grid to 2000 millimeters, and then for the horizontal grid to 3000 millimeters. I'm also going to change the curtain panel from glazed into solid because I want this to be completely solid, and then we'll add the windows later on. Now it's going to look like this, so it even looks worse. That's completely fine. So just to make it look a bit nicer right away, I'm just going to go to one of the panels, hit the tab key a few times until I highlight it, select it, and then go here to edit type. And here I'm just going to change the material from this default material into my paint material, which I've used for the rest of the building. And it's just going to give it that white color. Also, while we're here, let's change the offset to 0 and change the thickness of the panel to 40 millimeters and then hit apply. Okay, and now it looks like this and it's a lot cleaner and a lot nicer. Okay, moving forward, the next step is going to be to make sure that we cover here the bottom of this floor, because this doesn't look very nice. So I'm just going to go into level 2. And here in level 2, I'm going to zoom into our curtain wall, and then I'm going to select it and move it from the inside edge and place it here. Now it is going to unconnect this or unjoin these elements from the walls. That's okay. Here we can delete a few elements if necessary. And now I'm just going to align these walls with the align tool, with the face of this curtain wall, just like that, and here as well. Okay, now let's go to the 3D view, see what that looks like, and as you can see, it's a lot cleaner and a lot nicer. Also here on top, I don't want it to look like this, so I'm just going to bring this down a little bit, and then I'm just going to align it with the align tool with the bottom of this floor, just like that. And now we need to add a wall here on top. So for that, let's go to level 8. And then in level 8, I'm just going to go to architecture, wall, generic 300 millimeter. And then let's set this to unconnected 600 millimeter and connect these two like so and see what that looks like. Okay, this does seem to look okay. I'm just going to bring this down to the top of that curtain wall, and then perhaps we can extend this floor to match that wall like that. I'm not going to attach it at this time. And there we go. So now it looks a lot cleaner. We have our curtain wall, and now it's time to work on the layout itself. So for the layout, what I'm going to do first is I'm just going to select this curtain wall, and then I'm going to make some changes to the grids. So for the grids, when you hover over one of the mullions and hit the tab key a few times, at some point it's going to say, see how it says grid line? You want that. Now when you select it, it's going to be pinned in place. So I'm just going to unpin it and then move it off to the side like that. Then I'm going to select this one. So again, just a tab key a few times until we select it or highlight it, and then move that here. Then for this one, let's see, I'm just going to use again the tab key a few times and move it away to this side, something like that. Okay, this seems to look okay. Now, I'm just using the picture that I've shown you in the beginning of this video. I found that online and thought it looks really cool. So I'm just going to follow that as reference to set up the layout here. So the first step is going to be to remove some of these panels and replace them with glass. So I'm just going to use the tab key once or a few times until I highlight the panel itself. When you highlight the panel, you click to select, you unpin it, and then you can change this to glass. So now it's back to glass, but only for that specific panel. I'm going to do the same thing for this panel. So again, just turn it into glass, unpin it, and turn it into glass. That one looks nice. Now looking down here, I have one more of these big guys here, so make it glass. Then I have a smaller one that should be here. So I'm just going to, turn this into glass as well by using the tab key. Okay, so now we have the basic layout, but we need to make some additional changes here. So the first problem is here we have this mullion, which I actually don't want to see. So if you want to remove a mullion, you don't just select it, unpin it, and delete it, because it's still going to keep the grid line there. What you want to do is you want to select that grid, go to add remove segments, and then remove it completely like so. So this is the result. This is what we're looking for. For example, also here, I don't want to see this grid line. So I'm just going to use the tab key a few times to select the grid, go to add remove segments and remove this one. So as you can see, it's going to remove the grid line as well as the mullion. Now, in some cases, you might want to add a window where we don't really have any grids. And for that, we need to go here to curtain grid, one segment, and then we can add a segment like this and like that. And now we have a segment there, which I can now select, unpin that glass or that solid panel, replace it with glass. And this is what that's going to look like. So basically you just continue doing this. So I'm just going to do one more to show you here. So one segment, and then I'm just going to add a segment like so, so now let's turn this into glass. And now, because I want to have another window just like this, but below over here, what I would do is I would find this grid line like that. So you just kind of hover over it, use the tab key a few times, you click to select, and then you go to add remove segments, and now you can add a segment there, see? And now here I can just select this, unpin it, and make it glazed as well. So it's going to look like this. Now, in order to get my kind of final facade design, I'm going to continue making some changes and edits in order to achieve that look at the end. And this is the end result that we get. This looks really, really nice. However, I do have something that's a bit annoying, and that's the fact that these mullions are so wide. So what I'm going to do now is just select the entire curtain wall, go here into edit type, and now we can change all of them over here. So I'm just going to pick out the smaller one with the 40 millimeters. It's still going to be the rectangular mullion, just set it to the 40 millimeter one, and make sure you do that on all of these vertical and horizontal mullions. Hit apply, okay. And now, as you can see, it's a lot thinner and it's a lot cleaner. And finally, one more edit that I'm going to do is going to be for these horizontal grids, because I want to move them a little bit up so it hides a bit of this floor slab. So I'm just going to unpin this and then just use my arrow keys to move that up just a little bit, so it's kind of centered on that floor slab. So let's do that here as well. So just unpin it and use the arrow keys to move it slightly up like so. Do the same thing here. And we have one more here. And yeah, that's it. Okay, there we go. This is the end result. It's a really interesting and unique facade. And as you can see, you can do it in just a few minutes. Now, if you would like to get access to this Revit project file or any of my other Revit project files, you can find that on my Patreon page, which I'm going to link up in the cards above, and then also down in the description of this video. Thank you for watching, guys. Make sure to check out my website, balkanarchitect.com, for more Revit courses. There I have over 120 hours of content, and I'm adding more each week. Make sure to subscribe for more videos, and also I've added a video over there that might interest you as well.